Okay. I apologize for that. There's a recruiter found me. So hopefully I'll have a couple more options in the near future. Would really like to. Okay, I'm just not gonna buy one of these guys unless I can get a revolt risk down. Advisor. Of course. The old infinite bad event. Religious regiments. What would that entail? It'd just be Tengri. This area is already Tengri. What's the point? Okay. There's a couple of provinces I can't get to. So I need to be able to get to those provinces before I can actually call Korea dead. I might just take the stab hit because I can't afford to run around and kill the rebels. Or I'll kill their rebels for them, that's fine. We're gonna do the same, I'm gonna take advantage. Just call for peace. They give me all my claims, all of them. I only have two claims, really. All my claims went away. Oh, damn it. Well, I want a lot more than my claims. You know what? This is fine. Just give me what land I can take. All right. Then I need to go to Altai? Altai? Deal with these religious rebels, which I'm going to let spawn now. So I don't have to take the stab hit. That probably made Japan mad. Very mad. Okay, for some reason my men stopped. That's not good. I'll take the Japanese Royal Marriage because it doesn't hurt me. Okay, so I actually have the highest development I've had all game now. And I'm nearing the highest force limit. Then got this alliance with Korea back. Over there. Just cannot make money. Let's see if I can integrate Chukchi still. Damn it. I don't want to send him a gift. Actually, I kind of like these rebels, because they are going to convert provinces for me up here. So I'm going to let them do that a bit. That's fine, even if it does cause them to be a bit more rebellious in the short term. All the good events that are supposed to be in this game. What happened to them? I also want to do what? What was it doing? Telling us the true faith would be pretty good. Maybe I should get a little more religious idea. Hooray, free conversion. Go north. That's fine too. Positive income, what happened? barely passive income. If I'm honest, I need you to like me a little more, please. Yeah, I don't think it's happening. It's not worth my, I'm not gonna send the money. I need money. I need a lot of things right now. I'm so far behind on everything. Where are you going? Are you going toward my army? I'll arrive next month, so I'm going to pay my army briefly. Get that morale tick. Take the fight and then reduce payment again. How do I pay him at all? What have they ever done for me? The guy in Delhi or allies? Jeez. There's no out. So I take it you're playing Dark Souls. Coruscant's small enough to vassalize. I've got no allies right now. But I am incredibly unstable. Is that a boss or something? Let's take a look at my trade. Maybe I can rejigger my trade. I make like no trade. I need to control Beijing, that's what I need. If I controlled Beijing and Hangzhou, I'd have a lot of power. Ming has a billion allies that are all equal or stronger to me, except for Utsang. Actually, Utsang is probably as strong as me now. It's got Bengal. I gotta pay my army. I actually can't do this. Because natives will murder my colonial guards. I forgot about that. Here come the Koreans. So momentarily I am going to have to up my maintenance. If we're gonna pop anywhere, it's probably gonna be in Pyongyang. What? I have positive income? What? What happened? How? These promises I took just that good? Is Korea gonna turn my economy around? Oh wow. Apparently they fixed aggressive expansion, because I took land from Korea and now I have a massive amount of aggressive expansion in a lot of places. Actually, Timurids too. Which is bad, because if there's a coalition against me, I cannot stop it. Just not happening. Now my income is negative again. I don't really understand this. Now it's more negative. Granted, this is a good province, but still. Whoa. That was a good general, apparently. 4-3. Alright. Well, at least they're gone. The particulars will be gone shortly. Hey, Bridge. How's it going? They don't have any forts, so this could be a really easy war. Could be. Ottomans will help me, but I don't want them to. Find and kill that army. This will be the easiest war I've had all game. Probably about the weakest country I've fought all game as well. I like marrying empires, it's only good things. I just get bonuses. There we go. Cleanest war of the campaign. Now, Ottomans, if I wanted to fight Delhi, would not join me because you're allies. If I wanted to fight one of their allies, like Nogai, you wouldn't want to because I'm in another war. But if I deal with this first, to vassalize you, but I also want this land to have claim on. A claim on. You know what? No, I just want to vassalize him. Making me way too many enemies. But hey, I need it. I gotta be bold at this point if I want to make progress. I think that would be my first step into Persia. Let's try to make them not hate me so much for taking away their freedom at the moment of their birth. Now, rebels. Not really a problem, not so much a problem. Let's take all my armies, move them west. This fort is... one of these forts is redone. Oh, great. I'm gonna wait on that one. Most is to attack Delhi to get my cores back. To do that, I'm going to need Ottoman help. If I want Ottoman help, I've got to go through Nogai. And Nogai would apparently not do it anymore. Because... I've got a royal marriage. Every turn. Alright, Delhi, how big is your army? Hundred thousand troops. Off the back of my land. They seem to get more out of it than I do. I've never been close to that, and half of their land was my land. Ming's hosting 140,000 troops with their 99 force limit, because they're just that rich and they want to show off, I guess. I'm not sure who to attack again. Looks like I did get an extension on my cores. At some point I need to hit Delhi and hit him hard. Positive income and I'm paying my armies. I really don't understand how I shifted a solid, like, 20 ducats after those two wars of income. I betcha diplomatic tech has a lot to do with this. Yeah, 30%. Maybe I should invest in some. Just maybe. Force limit's up to 83. I think that breaks my record. I don't pay for reinforcements, so I'm going to help them with their rebel problem. Make them like me a little more. I'll do the de-sieging because I think you get a better bonus for that. Utsang might actually ally me. If they weren't so damn greedy. Let's improve relations. Let's see if we can get them. An ally is an ally. Malacca would ally me. They're allied with Spain, too. Nobody'd mess with Malacca. Colonial enthusiasm back. Hey, Trissy. No, it's not. The funny thing is, this is the strongest I've been. Yeah, I just really wanted to play. Usually I wait because, A, I might get job-related calls, which did happen in the middle of the stream, and B, I don't know, consistency. But it's not like anything else I have to do today. So, could I kill Delhi? Delhi has more troops than I have force limit. So I have to have the Ottomans in on it if I go to war with Delhi. and the Delhi is allied with the Ottomans. But they have so much of my land that I want back. All these superpowers are allied with all these other people, and I can't break through. Still. Think I'll get anywhere? If I were to guess, unless something really bad happens, and that has been consistently occurring, I might get like two-thirds, halfway the way there. If I could crack through the people that have a lot of my cores, I could actually gain a lot of strength really fast. But I'd actually have to make progress somewhere. And that just hasn't been happening. Although in this session I've made the most positive gain that I've made since the very beginning, so got that going for me. Should probably leave this fort on. Probably another war or two and I can be an empire. When was the last time I got a good event? I don't know. I'm not sure. Like, I've been getting this one repeatedly. This is pretty great. So I've just been dumping all my money into that instead of loans. Because I need the admin power very badly. Someone's got to get into a war sometime, right? That doesn't involve me. You see this? I'm gonna have to take another loan. Because I can't spend all my admin on stab. Bad events are one thing, but when you're in an extremely weak position and you don't have any resources, it becomes nearly unbearable. Let's see, where am I going to go after these islands? Do I have boats still? I actually have no navy. I'm paying an interest of 11 ducats a month. So if I could actually pay some of these off, I actually can repay one now. Everybody's in perpetual peace. Okay, Utsang will ally me. I'm at 4 out of 4 relations, but I don't need the dip points. And they're going to be moderately powerful, I bet you. Because they've got that Bengali land. They're incredibly weak. Whatever. USA formed. I just noticed. They are Dutch. And Mexico, who's also Dutch. Apparently the Dutch just lost everything. All the colonies. Brazil, I bet that's Dutch, yep. I actually have done Sunset Invasion. That was a fun campaign. That went so much smoother than this. So much smoother. If you want to see that one, that's one of the ones that's up on YouTube. I did Sunset Invasion right after the Aztec religion came out. Now, relative to how this has been, Sunset Invasion was incredibly easy. I actually think Ceylon was harder. There's a bunch of campaigns I want to do. Let's see. Big Blue Blob. Sounds pretty good. There's some other ones. Let me look at my spreadsheet. I'd like to play Scotland at some point. That sounds pretty good. At the moment, that sounds the most entertaining to me. Scotland. Are you kidding me? Oh, what? Oh, it's my ally. I was reading this backwards. Yeah, all the lines are reversed. I can also get One Night in Paris done with that campaign. Just take Paris on the way and form Great Britain. Ah, my alliance. My truce ended with Timurids. They're allied with Malwa. Malwa is looking pretty strong. So many M's. Yeah. Having so few allies is really crippling. Especially having so few allies actually willing to help. The Timurids are still incredibly weak. The Maul was pretty tough. Got no revolt risk whatsoever. Balmanis, I'm surprised Balmanis hasn't formed Hindustan yet. Or, yeah, Hindustan. You know what? Investing in a navy might actually help me a lot, because everybody's hating me because of my naval strength. Not that a navy would do me much. I guess I could put them in Beijing. Have them push money forward. My diplomatic navy, my white fleet. Got another huge tactics bonus coming up. I think he's actually starting to keep up with me now. That's not good. But everybody else around here is lagging so far behind that this might be viable in the near future. Let's see. Big problem is everybody's armies are huge. Russian seems to be having a problem. I don't even have another kind of monarchy unlocked. I guess I can do that right now. Administrative? Do I want administrative? I should probably be checking up anyway, though. It only cost me 95, 131, and I'll have another idea group. pretty soon I want to put it into military after the next Miltech, because I'll have caught up with the rest of the world. Except for France and Spain, who are ahead. No, they're caught up. I'm just behind by one. So I want some military ideas. Quantity, I don't think I can afford. Although it would really help me not to have to rely on mercenaries for everything. Defensive actually matches really well with my idea groups, my ideas, my national ideas, because land attrition minus 25 on top of land attrition minus 20. Pretty solid. Morale is never bad. Maintenance down is never bad. I actually wasn't aware of the maneuver bonus. I kind of ignored that in the past, I guess. Reinforced speed is really good for me because it's free. Offensive might be pretty good. Although I really like offensive for the siege ability and the extra pips and the discipline. Timurids are back to being incredibly stable. Jeez. After I tech up, it might be a good idea to build up my army, attack Timurids with the Ottomans on my side, and then immediately attack Delhi. What that's going to do for me is keep Ottomans out of it. I still have to deal with... Well, I can't do it if Bahmanis is in there. Good event! Check that out. Religious event. Clergy mobilizes population. So, in theory, if you had a low stab, the game would naturally try to nudge you. This is what I've read. The game would naturally try to nudge you towards zero. If you have high stab, it would try to nudge you towards zero as well. I don't know if there's anything to back that up. I don't even remember where I heard it. But I think it was from a dev or someone who talked to the devs. But in practice, I don't really put much faith in that, so... If you have a stab, then take it away. Yeah, fair enough. Delhi gets ever bigger. And of course they're gonna have no chance of a coalition, I'm sure, because the game does not. Wow. Not even a little bit. Yeah, the game, the way the game's set up now with such a high, the AI is just never gonna get coalitioned. Just about. Their blobbing restriction has been removed. Suppose I could target Korea and Ming again. Try to get my cores back from them. Certainly don't want to attack Ming directly because they have enormous allies in the south. It's tempting to ally Malacca. Not that they're very strong. Suppose I could just attack Timurids. Delhi's aggressive expansion with me is going to get super high. That's scary. Malwa will ally me. Their former ally. Actually, that's pretty good. You know what's funny? I could return Timurid cores to Timurids by surrendering to them, or surrendering to someone while the Ottomans are on my side. Yeah, I'm perfectly happy going over my diplo relations limit if I can get another alliance. Oh, there were with Spain. Spanish conquest of Malwa. Well then. Maybe the Spanish will get close enough that I can ally them. But they hit the autos, so maybe not. Yep, I think the right thing to do is just to attack the Timurids. Keep hitting them while they're weak. Just gonna claim on Tashkent. Go for it. Not that I have the admin power. I'm spending all on tech. But I can give a lot of land to Coruscant. Hello. As for my vassal, let's go ahead and siege. If he's gonna siege that, I'll step off and let him do it. I'll just continue to ensure that the battle's going away. Making room. I'm still making money, so I can actually pay off loans while I'm doing this. Are you kidding me? I'm gonna take the stability hit. I really need admin power right now. But I can handle one stab down. Don't have the resources for this game. Yep. This campaign has been, inordinately rough. Let me see if I just gave up. I mean, so if you keep at it in a bad situation, you get better at dealing with bad situations. I'll certainly never what? Why do they have a, I had a boat here? I've got my transport fleet. I have no idea what that was. I didn't have boats before I built those other boats, so how would I... Oh! Chukchi had a boat. Not anymore. All right, that army is going to seize, and this army is going to split. Let's get this done. Yeah, and another thing is, I wouldn't be playing right now. Like, usually I'd wait till the evening to play. But right now, today, I just kept thinking about it. I had to get back in this. And part of the reason is, it's way more exciting because it's going so badly. It makes it a lot of fun. At the very least, one of my major allies is finally cracked. The thing I've been waiting for the entire game. Sadly, it is the weakest of them. Which is also why it happened to them. But at least progress can be made in some direction. Believe that things that are held actually cost less to take. If I remember right. So I'm going to keep sieging even though I have 100%. Essentially that much. I'm not going to get 100% because I'm not going to take these little islands because I have no navy. Ottomans allied Nagai again. I'm rival to them, so that'll probably mean I'm gonna lose Nagai. Or Ottomans is an ally, so I should unrival Nagai as soon as possible. Actually, it's kinda tempting just to peace out right now. Get out of this. For that very reason. Alright, those are my claims. That'll get me 28 over extension. It costs 29. So what can I hand to Khorasan that is going to give them... I need 70 over... or 70 war score worth. Anything worth 7. Okay. So I can give that to them. They won't be too overextended. Oh, I do need to siege these. So I can transfer to them. I believe that was the deal, 70%. There we go. And then on top of that, I take my claims. Which were these. I'm glad they updated this tooltip, because you couldn't tell. I had trouble telling what exactly it meant before. But now I can tell the Timurids are going to gain 63, putting them at 152, instead of just a number. With no, And hey, I'll gain 50 power projection. Naval race versus Russia have larger than 35. Sounds terrible. Okay, so. Another victory under my belt. Trying to boost autonomy in these new lands. Of course, Sun's gonna have to be placated. Yep, there goes the Ottomans. I was afraid of that. I don't even have enough. Oh, I do have enough land for Empire. I need 75 prestige, though, and I can't really get that right now. Alright, well, there goes the Ottomans. So long, potential alliances. They absolutely hate me now because they decided they want all my land. Get Lanshan though. It's 41,000 troops. Is Malwa still willing? No, they hate me now. Because of aggressive expansion. But they're fighting Delhi. I'm so tempted to go after Delhi right now. I could get my cores back if I won. I like how this says the Ottomans are my ally still. War with the Ottomans. The Ottomans can't help them because they can't get through. Delhi has Tech 19 now, so they're actually not a viable target for war until I get Tech 23. Oh my, this is in more debt than I am. Holy crap. Yeah, I don't know who to attack now. I could do Korea. Bring Ming in. But they're at tech 20. Which means they'll be way stronger than me, too. Spain, I see. It is. Let's improve relations to Spain. With the loss of the Ottoman alliance, that might open up some options overseas. Still don't like me very much. And yet, Malacca got allied to them. Interesting. Commonwealth improved relations with me. Yeah, I'm actually making decent money now. I've had positive income for a while. My new acquisitions are already paying off. Which song wants a royal marriage? I'm okay with that. I'll start integrating Coruscant somewhat soon. I'd rather have the land for than myself. Yeah, that'll keep them a little happier. That means chilled out a little bit. Might as well improve relations. So if I can get that alliance back, it'll be huge. Force limit's up to 88. Someday I'll be at 100. Then they'll see. They'll all see. And they got no aggressive expansion for it. I do not understand why. No, maybe I should get quantity. I am making money now. Not a lot, but I am making some. That province loves to have events regarding rebels. I can't believe the Ottomans allied Delhi. Ah, so dumb. Same religion. Yeah, I don't see why. I don't see why they would do that. I guess Delhi just got strong enough off of my losses. Glad it helps you out, Tristan. Well, I'm glad you enjoy my failures. Even in a good campaign, it's usually a string of failures that just happens to come together. How's Spain feel now? Not even worth their time. Commonwealth. Gambled and it worked out. I do not want to deal with rebels. This is more stuff slowing me down. Separatists. Tashkent, oh, that's just because I'm just converting it. Don't you worry. Yeah, I'll reset if it's like the beginning of a campaign and I have an opening I want to try, because it's not that big of a waste of time. Maybe 2 hours. But if I'm this far in, I might as well try. Okay, I'm gonna get a drink. I'll be right back. Okay. So what do we have here? I've got my navy that's about to die. My favorite part of this is that Utsang, Ming's forever ally, is now on my side. Okay, Korea and Lanshang joined in. Lanshang's miltech is ignorable. Ming is very strong. Korea is actually got terrible miltech too. I'm about to tech up. So this is about as good of a time as any for them to declare war on me. I'm pretty positive I can get my cores back in this. Now, the downside would be that everybody else is going to look at me and go, oh, easy target. And I'm probably going to end up losing land again, like the last couple times. So the first thing I'm going to have to do is build another army. I've got 25,000 force limit available. And this will be where they center around. So, let's pick a template. Let's do 25,000, huh? 10, 10. Is that my phone? Where was my phone? And 5. That sounds good to me. And I am going to have to go into debt for this again. There's just no way to avoid it. And I don't have enough money, so I'm gonna have to take a loan immediately. Alright, and the rest of my troops, come on over. This is a time of war. As for my forts, I need to raise them. All 5 of them. Oh, so much for having a navy. Welcome back to Massive Debt, the game. First things first, I want Korea out of the war. Same as before. The only big problem here is that Lanshang is going to be in this. October I can tech up, and that's when I'll go on the offensive. Oh, jeez. I can't actually stop this from happening, so... Oh well, manpower. Yep, this is the seventh that I remember war where I've been declared on in this campaign. I believe that breaks all my records. I think there might have been more too, I'm just not thinking of. Don't see a point in continuing? Well, I see it as a chance to see what I can pull off. It's not even 1700 yet. And you do accelerate quite a bit as the game goes on. So I'm not seeing it as impossible. Picture this. What if I defeated the Timurids in Russia and got all their land? I could win in one war by as long as Ming doesn't westernize. But it's not zero. I've gained land. I have empire quality. I have enough land for an empire now. Enough development. My army tradition has dropped, I'd like to note, despite all the war. We have 1,000 development, it looks like 300. I know I have over 1,000 because this isn't telling me. I need 1,000. I forget where to see the number. No, it's out there somewhere. Economy? 1,028. I can't go to my own province because it's blocked by a fort. All right. There we go. That was weird. Okay, forget Ming entirely. I'm going straight for Korea. Every nation and knockout of this is going to be huge. At least once a year, there's a stability hit event. Let's just hope a giant stack doesn't come and kill me. If they do, well, that's how this goes. Korea's already in large part occupied, so hopefully. Make enough progress here. Will they destroy Utsang? Looks like there's a chance they might let me do it. This is where Russia and Delhi simultaneously attacked me. Actually, if they're gonna have no armies here at all, I'm just gonna send a couple of guys around and de-siege. Well, Utsang is out, which means they're going to be swarming this way. So hopefully these sieges finish first. they give up? Not their alliance. Conquest of Hami. Okay. So I should focus around keeping that. All right. Korea. About that alliance we have. The Chinese. That's not happening anymore, for one. Second, you're gonna give me all your money, and you're gonna help fund the rest of this war. I'm kinda thinking I want some land from you, too. That's a lot of aggressive expansion. That's insane aggressive expansion. Must be a damn good province. Oh yeah, it is. You don't want to give me anything though? No land. That's fine, I'll come and take land later. Alright, they're out. What am I even doing? What do you mean? Taking 30,000 men out of this war. That's what I'm doing. Yeah. You are correct. However, for the moment, they have a whole bunch of my cores. There's also the idea that if I protectorate them now, and they either fall apart or westernize, it would have been for nothing. Oh, I'm gonna take Beijing, it's my core. Absolute taking Beijing. Yeah, but, okay, so if I protectorated them now, it would cost 100% of the war score. They lose Mandate of Heaven if they're a protectorate? If you can confirm that for me, I might just go for it. Here goes. Now, they're at tech 20. I'm at tech 23. It's an okay advantage. But they're gonna have way more morale than me. Well, that's 50,000. I still have 75,000 that I can see to deal with. I don't imagine Lan Chang's going to drop out of this very soon. Kara-san doesn't seem very willing to help either. Maybe I ought to set him to be supportive. Mandate of Heaven. As long as Ming is not Western or Westernizing, has factions, at least 20 provinces, stability of 0 or more, and legitimacy of 60 or more, the Mandate of Heaven will be active. Yes, I vassalized Coruscant. Jeez. Here we go. Get ready for this forever. Thousand more coming. I'm just gonna back out. There's no way I can do both of these. Plus, if I'm back in my land, I'll restore my men faster. I don't know if I can do this. This is too many. Granted, they're gonna run out of men eventually. Eventually that fort's gotta fall. Let's just see if it's westernized or westernizing. Westernizing. Off of what? They don't even border a western state. Oh, they do. Holland. He's gonna come up here. He's probably not gonna stop. No, he did stop. Please finish the siege. If half the army leaves. No, Ming is not westernizing. Siak. Might as well repay the loan. If I take a new one, it'll be bigger at least. In the meantime, I pay less. Okay, so they've got 100,000 men right there. But the war goal is over here, so I'm just gonna mosey on that way, if they don't mind. I'm gonna take a massive amount of attrition unless I back one out and move the long way around. I'll still take attrition, just not as much. I'd love to make a diversion to kill Lanshang. But I don't really see that happening right now. And again. Now they're going the wrong way. Good, Lanshang was in that. Things are already out of manpower. Oh, free colonial enthusiasm, that's nice. It's very nice. So they're coming for me or my capital, I'm not sure which. it turned around. Okay. I'll take it. Alright, let's get the hell out of there. That's not gonna go well. Even numbers, I might be able to defeat him with his demigod general. I'd prefer not to give them even numbers, though. On Shanks on the medium. And after that, I just have to deal with 150,000 Chinese. All going to one place. Mountains here. Maybe I should just go for Datong. But I don't want him to take the war goal either. So I'll have to stick with Jiangye. He's gonna get my capital. There's nothing I can do about it. And I can't get to his capital because it's right in the middle of the continent. This is hemorrhaging manpower by doing that. He's 50 over his own damn force limit. Friggin' Ming. I think I can beat 150,000 of them. Oh, well, this is really bad. There's no avoiding it now. Alright, well, can I get out of here? At least I've got that. I'm trying to suddenly add high, Morg's enthusiasm. Might as well get my capital back. Not much else I can do. Says his enthusiasm is high, but the number keeps dropping. He's getting close. Not that he's ever really engaged me. Deli. I know. Oh yeah. Won a battle. About to lose another one. The Ottomans have imperialism, CB. Wow, I destroyed that stack. We lost about 30,000 men there. And suddenly he's like, low enthusiasm. I honestly think it's more important to kill Ning's troops right now. Nice of them to come to me like this. And a little at a time. They must have destroyed my navy. Hey, Bader. What kind of crazy shit? Today, of all days, I sympathize with you, Bader. Mongolia with a perfectly stable Ming, Russia, and up until very recently, Khorasan, or Timurids. And I've been declared on 7 or 8 times. And I've lost 3 of those losing land. I've been really good, actually. Okay, I'm a half hour past the cat's usual feeding time, so I'm gonna go take care of that real fast. Be right back. Let's lose some more. I gotta get my capital back, and then I gotta go snatch the war goal. Of course, Delhi is coming now. How do I get involved in these wars? Oh, they happened to me. This was not of my choosing. I don't have to go looking for wars. Wars come to me. Okay, suddenly Ming just gained 10. Oh, because Japan dropped out. Still tempted to drop defensive and just go something like quantity. Although that morale boost would really help. Nope, I did before, and then they took all their land back, and now they're taking even more land. So this is unprovoked. They simply hate me for being a glorious, perfect Tengri. I might be able to white piece them and just focus on Delhi. They wonder why I can't get allies. I don't know, man. Has nothing to do with me being a pagan. Surely. And having no navy. Which gives a minus 20 to literally everyone for wanting to be my ally. If I was Sunni, this might have gone differently. I had the Ottomans as an ally for a while, which is the only reason I broke into the Timurids, which, like Ming, were 100% stable until then. I'm gonna have positive war score after I take this back. Immediately gonna look at this 21% right off the bat. He's got a 2 siege general, probably like offensive or something to have that good of a siege. No, he's just I don't know how the AI does it sometimes. You get these bonuses, and I don't understand them. Might be a main thing. No idea. Okay, I'm officially winning this war. So I'm gonna get my capital back and see if I can get positive war score and get like war reps or something. Maybe I'm pushing my luck. But Delius doesn't have that much on me. Screw this. The Delhi army is divided. So I can take half of it at a time. Of course, the forts that he took from me mean that I can't actually pass through this area, and he can. And of course, the AI has managed to have high army tradition where I haven't been able to break 20. Okay, where's he going? I don't know, but maybe I should take back all my land first. Okay. This stack will go up here. The other one will follow behind and start desieging. Khorasan is just, despite being loyal, is not left at all. Not for anything. They've been convinced Japan to come out here. Just set a war goal. Oh, it worked. He's moving. I had to explicitly tell him to do it. Of course, Delhi's immediately gonna smash him down. Now, this is a war for Tashkent. It's an interesting alternate route this one's taking. In fact, we'll just stop. Desiege. Not gonna lie, if somebody else declares war on me right now, I'd be pretty tempted to just stop. Probably better off canceling this, since it's gonna just get destroyed. I'm using half of this. There. Yep. Come. Maybe not. I feel like I'm playing Dark Souls. Alright. There's 100,000 deli men. They have burned most of their manpower doing this, though. I suppose that is, in a way, encouraging. So, Xiaowu, how you doing? More exhaustion. No. Oh. Or he's not going for it. 25th, 20th, I can get up. Just cancel the rest. What religion? Oh, well, that is the one thing that I have truly succeeded on. And that is, I am glorious Tengri. Of course, I'm paying very dearly for that, since I can't get any allies, and, well, everybody hates me. If they want to keep running around, I'll let them. Siege up my force back. What mechanics does Tengri have? Okay, let's take a look. So Tengri gives you global national unrest minus 2, regardless of whether the province has the religion, and regiment costs minus 10%. It also has some decision. So you have a choice between yellow shamanism and black shamanism. Yellow shamanism gives you tolerance of heathens plus 2. So all the stuff I'm taking over, when I first converted, I was pretty much necessary to not have revolts everywhere all the time. The other choice is black shamanism. You can only take one, as I discovered. And black shamanism gives you 2% more conversion strength, which I believe is what Najd has nowadays. It's 2 or 3. So, coupled with religion, you could be really good. You thought it had Buddhist stuff? No, it's not Buddhist. It does have a decision attached to it to convert to Buddhism. And I found that that's not unique to Mongolia. Well, this is bad. Here we go. That's not unique to Mongolia, because I gave it to one of the. Wait a minute. Oh, he's coming here. Good. Come on, back up. Come on, back up. Win before they get here. Win before they get here. It is not counted as Buddhist, it is counted as pagan. In order to become Tengri, I had to flip to. Since you can't be forced into Tengri from breaking, if you are not already a pagan, I had to force myself to become animist by letting myself break to animists. And then. What is this? I'll take the prestige. Yeah, so I had to let myself become animist, and then I could switch to Tengri. It's a very time-consuming process. Yay, the king is dead! Long live the king! That was terrible error. Wait, Kievan Separatists? That's actually fine, because the... I bet Delhi will take care of it for me. That is not fine, however. I probably want to stab up to get rid of this. These. Since I can't get rid of my war exhaustion. I guess it doesn't get rid of it, does it? Not totally. Actually, it didn't do anything. What? Oh, because it's in the provinces that are held by someone else. I'm an idiot. So it doesn't do jack for me. Meanwhile, Hero Merc, besieging provinces. Two red forts don't do anything. I really don't understand. There's gotta be a pattern. Even if it is a bug, there's gotta be a pattern. Nothing has been retaken by any forts in my entire domain at any point during this campaign. I don't know why. Okay. Should my priority be taking my land back, or should my priority be taking their land? You don't think a horde's fort actually does anything? Well, funny thing about that. I'm a despotic monarchy, and I'm Western. Another big battling is going to be out of manpower. Let's get all my terrible, terrible land back. I have cleansing of the heresy against Ternate. Wait a minute. How? I'm considering bordering them somehow? I'm not even. Oh, that's Ternate. They ate these guys. Okay, that makes sense. I'm also going to be destroying their alliances with Ottomans and Bahmanis. I don't really care about Nagai. I'm gonna grab Tashkent because that's the war goal, and that's gonna flip quite a bit of power here. Oh yeah, that'll actually give me positive war score combined with that battle. Alright, I would like some numbers on my side, so Khorasan, would you please. Oh, you're supposed to be supportive. Well, damn it, Khorasan, will you please do your job? Here they come. Oh, he's got, like, all the cannons. I could just take that army. As soon as he walks into, like, grasslands or something. Why does this army have no leader? What am I converting? Merv? Oh, I still control Merv. Perfect. It's, convenient. Who's Kend? It's going here. Well, could I also go there? Would he allow that? I stopped. Alright, everybody else, we need to pile in someplace defense somewhat controlled. He's coming with the numbers now. Just recall everybody. Hey, I'm almost done converting. Whoa, what is this trip doing? No. No, 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 what are you doing? Oh, he was stuck. Well, goodbye. Holy crap, 50,000 more just sitting here? He's not moving anymore. makes me want to attack him. Of course, he's, oh, he's moving. He's most definitely moving now. And he is winning. Holy crap. Go, because I have no general here. Where are my generals? Coruscant's general is coming in. Alright. 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 Whew. I'm really glad I don't pay for reinforcements. You know what? I'm not gonna need any admin for this war. I'm gonna stay on my side though, because I need to recover my men faster than he needs to recover his men. He's mostly mercenaries, which is a good sign for me. Surprisingly, I'm still on my own manpower. I don't technically have a deficit. Alright, I have a little time. I'm gonna split up. Take as many of these back as I can. Hopefully, peasant rebels don't pop up and kill a bunch of these. I don't want to have to take another loan just to make an army. And this army will serve as a general defense force. Try to stay in the middle of all the other ones. The biggest reason those battles are so hard, despite my advanced tactics bonus, is that they have, to their credit, a lot of morale. They have really high prestige, I'm sure they have military ideas somewhere. They got quantity, they have offensive. And I just haven't been able to afford military ideas. But the trade-off is that I'm way ahead on tech. There's a small stack going somewhere. Somewhat inclined to chase it down. Ah, they're going for the war goal, of course. Well, I have something to say about that. Let's bring in potential backup, which I'll need. After this, I can start taking their land. Okay, please come in. Back up. Alright. RIP, both our manpowers. One more instance of peasants left in Kuka. Oh. Which one? EU4 or Dark Souls? Some of these are not routed, and I don't know which. Here, one of them. It's very small. So can I reach it in time? It leaves on February the 3rd, and I get there on the 4th. Damn. Well, I can at least take their province. My province. Take my province back. I thought that was like the allure of Dark Souls. You play it because you want to be punished. Let's not be having those separatists, please. Kuka. So I can save that in time. Looks like I can stop the Mongol peasants. All rebellions averted. Now, if only I could actually take this fort. I have to take at least one fort in order to get my land back, I believe. Unless it's done as a return core. Which apparently I'm not allowed to do. Okay. Whatever you're offering, Deli, it won't be good enough. You have to be punished for your crimes. We'll cross a river. He's gonna run into my army? Okay. Wonder if I can lure him here, actually. If I back out. If I back out of Tashkent. Can we walk in? No? Alright. I might as well attack him before the rest of them come show up again. Interesting choice of route, but okay. Arriving Kotkor. Oh, it's going to my land. That's acceptable. I'm still going to Tashkent. Good luck with it. I'm liking those events that give me. Oh, whoa, okay. Looks like you teleported. I'm liking the events that let me pay for war exhaustion reduction. I don't want to just jump on this one, considering how well he did in that last fight. Not with a two-shock general. I can't believe I still have manpower. Okay, he might be going for Coruscant's army. Which will melt because Coruscant's tech is terrible. Yeah. When he does, when he locks. Actually, I'll help with these guys now. And as soon as he locks, I'll send the rest. Let's send more. Actually, I will send more. That just won't help the siege for a while. Alright, come on, bring them back. The Ottomans have been unable to hold on to Jaffa and have been forced to return it to Tunis. Are they unable to core all this land or something? I've never seen the AI do that. Okay, I'm getting to the point where I do have to manage my men a bit. So let's take all the infantry. Split out the mercs. Merge the regulars. Consolidate what's left. And I'll see how many mercs I can make out of that. Three more? I only lost three. That's good. I'll just make three mercs instead. Delhi's war exhaustion's getting pretty high. Got some revolt risk back home. Okay, finally, I got the siege. Now on to the next one. Ever so slowly. I'll take control here. Please tell me they're actually going to go here. Oh, yes. Free kills. That'll be a stack wipe, too. So now they have 15 mercenaries, and they're down to 35,000 men. May be able to afford starting to take two provinces at once. Where's their capital? Oh, they moved it back to Delhi. Of course, they come up on the other side. That's fine. As long as we're all on this mountain. He's probably going to go for the war goal. I was going for his fort. Well, that's ill-advised. Oh yeah, I'm allowed to walk right through here. What would they offer me now? Give me a whole bunch of land. I want more. Oh, I got finished the other school. When did that happen? That means I can afford to take everyone and go kill him. Knock him out of the siege, and then I can take two forts at once. This theoretically shouldn't be a problem, but this isn't going as well as I would have liked. There we go. It's his king, too, so I might kill his king. You go to that fort, you go to that fort. I think I can risk splitting up now. Although, these guys need to merge. Actually, you're all in the same place. Let's merge the entire army, take out the infantry, merge them, merge split, and we're still balanced stacks. Coruscango. Ah, he was hiding. Do I have to be afraid of that stack? I'm just not sure. This is mountains. I didn't want prestige or anything anyway. Who needs that? I think he can actually beat either of these. He could just go for it. Slightly unnerving. Call for peace. Damn it. How much more can I get? I'll take these two forts and then I'll call it. That'll let me siege up all the land that should go to me anyway. Let's take a look at how expensive this will be. I think this one is not my core. I have a claim, but it's not my core. Let's focus on cores. Yeah, that's what I want. All my cores back, all at once. Everything they've taken from me in their two wars. The war exhaustion's worth it. Since they are cores, they'll have no autonomy, I think. I'm not used to taking cores back that have been stolen from me. Or maybe they just won't get additional autonomy? Take a look at that. So, any of these have autonomy? No. Come on then, take the forts. They seem unwilling to fight me. They won't give it back? The fifth. Fourth. I'll take this battle. Attacking over a river into mountains? Not a great idea. Not a great idea. I get them to end their treaty with the Ottomans? Not quite. I'm actually thinking that's more important than, like, some of this land. Don't have enough diplomatic power to enforce this demand. Are you kidding me? I am not happy about this right now. Nope. Not happy. Alright. So let's do things that don't cost dip power. war reparations, annulling your treaties with the Ottomans and Bamanas and Nagai. All of your money. And all the forts that you stole from me. Guess that's what I'm getting. One of those wasn't a core, but still. So yeah, no autonomy in any of these. Instantly useful. Pay off two loans right away. Alliance from Bamanas. That is the kind of news I've been wanting. Absolutely, sir. Let's take it. Annex Khorasan. Okay. The Ottomans hate me because they want a specific province. Mazandaran. Oh. This guy. Well, no. So, that's not happening. Delhi is too powerful still for me to guarantee and revoke. Ming's force limit went up to 178 somehow. Who did they fight while I was busy? No one? That's unnerving. Spain will ally me. It went friendly for some reason. I said Commonwealth. Commonwealth might be the better option, considering. Got 24 tech. They're poised to strike at Russia. Russia, whose only ally is Estonia. Well, they do got the P, they have the PU over Hungary. Austria is apparently irrelevant. Bohemia is the powerhouse in HRE, despite Austria being the emperor. France is actually getting strong again. Oh, Britain rivaled me? Why would Britain... Okay, whatever. They can't rival Ming. But they can rival Nagai. Well, if you say so. Could be an excellent time to strike at the Timurids. On whom I have no fabricated claims. This war has lasted so long that my aggressive expansion dropped to negligible. Between handing land to Khorasan and taking it from the Timurids, I have a bit of breathing room in terms of what I want to do there. Russia's going to be even more powerful than Ming. So I absolutely need a strong ally to fight them. I think Commonwealth is the more useful ally, because they can help me against the Ottomans and Russia. Both of whom will need to be dealt with. Timurids have no army. I could just go on them. I think I ought to, while I have the time and chance. I have a ton of war exhaustion. Oh, right, I wanted to get Absolute Monarchy, which will cost me a few more admin. Extra discipline, less unrest. Autonomy change on its own. Oh, radical reforms. Do I really have the com yeah, I do have the combo. Ooh. If I kick both of those, I can get 100 of each point type. Yeah, I think I want that. As much as I want to get rid of some of my inflation, I'd much rather have the points. I had the wrong one first. I have two idea groups available that just basically aren't being used. Defensive, I haven't put anything into, so I can just delete it at will. I feel like diplomatic is less useful as the game goes on, as you become powerful enough. But maybe not, because I still need a lot of strong allies, and I probably will for quite some time. I definitely don't want to use admin ideas because I have to core a lot of things already. We'll take diplomatic, let's consider defensive. Whether that's worth keeping. So long, Buddhists. Honestly, I probably only need one of these stacks here. I'll split this one and have them stand here. The other one, where's the other one? Army? Always gotta go the long way. Afghan separatists. Yeah, we'll see about that. So hit the Timurids, potentially hit Ming. That seems viable. Romanus hates them. Maybe they'll join me. I think together we could do it. Romanus is kept up in tech. Commonwealth would help me against Russia right off the bat. All I need from Russia is, this. I need this land. If I help Commonwealth kill Russia and just push in and take most of this, I'll have enough power to take from Commonwealth what they owe me. And this land, Got about half of now. I need that land. Which I have a... Oh, I have none of. Okay, no. Alright. Alright. I'm gonna take a break. I might come back later tonight if nothing more interesting comes up, I suppose. Don't wanna forget that. Don't wanna forget this either. Next 100 admin will be going to absolute monarchy. More discipline, less unrest. Not that the unrest has been a problem for quite some time. But eat into Russia, it's gonna have to be like chopping a section like this off to make all their Asian provinces useless. Stopping for now. I'll maybe come back later, maybe not. I don't know. You'll have to guess. Alright, have a good afternoon, everyone. Oh, and, 再见.